What's up guys, welcome back to Cube World, welcome back to yet another tutorial. This time we're gonna cover crafting in this game. More specifically, I'm gonna show you how to craft weapons. I got stuck in all those interfaces again. I'm gonna show you how to craft weapons, golden ones, purple ones, whatever you wish. Same for armor, same for amulets, so let's just jump right into it. Right, well, first things first, press C on your keyboard to open this crafting interface, and have in mind, it's likely you'll only see white items here, right off the bat. White weapons, white armor, and so on. To be able to see some higher tiers of items, you will need a specific item called, or actually multiple items, but they're mainly gonna be books. I'm gonna show you in a second. There you go. So I got here an epic book of crafting, and if you wish to get more info on this, such as where to get this item, feel free to check my special items in Cube World video, where I basically take a more in-depth look over where to find these books and what exactly they do. But what they do is rather simple. I should just mention it right away. They allow you to craft specific items. This one, the epic one, I believe it allows me to craft purple and blue items, and the legendary book of crafting is gonna let you craft the golden ones. So bottom line, once you have the legendary book of crafting, you are gonna be unlocking all golden weapons, armors, and amulets, giving you access to crafting such good items, right? Well, now that you have access and you can see the selection here, you gotta pick your favorite and try get the resources. For example, let's go for the best ones in here. This legendary bow is gonna ask you for 50 wooden cubes, 5 linen yarn, and 4 diamonds. Keep in mind, the requirements are gonna be different for every item in here. For example, the crossbow is gonna ask for some 10 extra iron cubes, 40 wood cubes, what else, 5 yarn, that's the same, and 4 diamonds, that being also the same. Is this the cheapest one to craft the boomerang? Judging by the resources alone, so it seems. This one seems to be the cheapest to craft. Only 50 cubes and 4 diamonds. I'm put cheap in quotes. It's not per se cheap. I mean, I'm gonna get into the resources in a second, but anyway. The lower tier ones are gonna follow the same pattern. They're gonna be asking for less wooden cubes, as you may expect, less linen yarn, and diamonds got replaced by rubies. But let's stay focused on the top tier right here, and let's say we wish to craft this splendid wooden bow. Well, we'll of course have to get the resources first, and let me explain, in the case of this bow, how to get each and every resource type. So first, for the wooden cubes, you will need logs. I think I have one such log in my inventory, if not multiple. There you go. Oh wow, I got plenty of wooden logs in my inventory. How you get these is rather simple. You'll have to find bushes. I'm gonna show you how one such bush looks like, and it can feel rather grindy. There were times that took me half an hour to gather around 20 logs, because bushes actually have a chance of not dropping any logs whatsoever. So keep that in mind. Arm yourself with some patience and start finding bushes. I'm gonna show you how one such bush looks like in a second, as soon as I find one. And there you have it, managed to spot one such bush. Let's see how many logs we're gonna end up with. Soon as we... Oh god. My damage in this zone is really crappy, as you can tell. And wow, no log whatsoever. So there you have it, what I said earlier. Well, you will need some plant fibers too, but more on that in a second. Until that, let me try and find another bush. And here we have another bush. Let's see how many logs for this one now. Anytime now, there you have it, one single log. But there you go, this is the only way of obtaining logs as of right now. So now that you have the log, you'll have to identify one of these saws in any single village. It's most likely gonna be marked by a saw icon right above the structure it's being housed in, and just simply approach it, press E, and that's how you get wooden cubes. It's gonna be a 1-to-1 ratio, except there's a chance at times you get you end up with 2 wooden cubes out of sheer luck. Which sounds pretty useful. And another tip would be, oh there you go, it just happened to me right there. Another tip would be to simply, oh, and again, lucky me, keep this pressed, and as you can notice, there you go, look at how drastic the speed increases. That's how you can craft multiple. Just keep your left mouse button pressed. There you have it, I can't craft, oh no, I cannot carry more of these actually. And I should now have, how many cubes I have? Out of curiosity, back to weapons. I have, there you go, 51 out of 50 cubes. Very well, done with the wooden cubes, let's move on to linen yarn. For this, you will need plant fiber, I believe it's called. Let me show you in a second, is it there? There you go, plant fiber. How you get this? Well, like so. Now, good news is you can get plant fiber from the bushes I've just showcased, which makes farming for bushes a little bit nicer, especially if they don't drop logs. Now, since I have plenty plant fiber, get it? Plenty plant fiber, I should just find a spinning wheel, and this is gonna be found under the shears icon on your village's map. So, just approach this, and as you can see, it's gonna be the same one-to-one ratio with a chance of getting a couple of drops. There you go. And that's also gonna be luck-based. I think that's enough, though, honestly, for what we need, and that's gonna be the first bow. I think I changed zones, so the bow styles might have changed. Anyway, final resource in here, which is gonna be the toughest to find, is gonna be comprised of diamonds. We need four of those, and there's two main ways of getting diamonds. First one, the hard way, is by simply finding them on your map in the world, by exploring pretty much. I think I know a location where I find where I found some diamonds. Hopefully they're gonna be some around again. And there you have it, guys. This is how one such diamond deposit looks like. You'll have to, of course, break it and get the diamonds. Oh, lucky drop. I just got three diamonds. Okay, so it may be easier than I thought. Good stuff. Good stuff. Let me also show you the other way of finding diamonds, which could be the more expensive method. The other way of finding diamonds is by locating a gnome trader. You've probably seen these guys lurk around. They usually lurk around cities, so just teleport near a city and try explore the surroundings a little until you stumble upon one such creature. They're mainly gonna trade the gems, so you can also buy rubies, sapphire, emeralds, whatever you may need. But in my case, and look at that, I'm gonna have to buy a diamond. That's gonna be 800 gold. Remember, I just saved 2.4 thousand gold by simply mining a diamond vein, and wow, I guess I got lucky getting three. But anyway, I just spent 800 gold to get one diamond. I find that pretty expensive, honestly. But well, diamonds are done, which means we have everything we need for our brand new golden bow. Thing is, last requirement would be a workbench, so back to the city. And guys, there you have it, this is how one such workbench is gonna look like. Click on the bow you wanna craft and just do it. There you have it, I got a magnificent wooden bow. Where is it? I can't really remember what it looked like. I think it's this one, right? Yeah, of Leiden. This is it right here, what a beauty. Cool. Oh no, I didn't want to drink that or eat that, whatever. Why, beauty indeed. Nice, and this is the basic principle behind crafting anything in this game, especially equipment for the crossbows. Oh, I guess I could also show you how the iron cubes are obtained while I'm on this topic, but these are the main resources for everything you may end up needing. The way you end up with iron blocks is basically the same as diamonds. You gotta find are these enemies? I don't know. You gotta find a mountainous region, and there's gonna be plenty all around. For example, what's this? Silver! This is also the way you get silver, of course. Let me grab this. Is that iron? Yeah, there you go, this is iron, the thing we were just talking about. I don't wanna fight a bat. Is my damage weak? No, my damage is actually quite decent. But yeah, there you have it. Oh, there's plenty silver and iron around, apparently. And this is how you find them. Once you get the resource, you'll have to go back to the village. And I'm gonna show you what to do in a second. So, get back to the village. This time, get next to a furnace. And simply turn your raw iron into iron cubes, just like so. Just like you've turned wooden cubes, except you had to use the saw previously, now you get, you'll have to use the furnace. Oh, gold is also found exactly the same way, just explore mountainous areas and you're gonna stumble upon that in no time. Well, depending on how lucky you are, it may take a while. Once you get these, well, it's the same crafting system. You will be able to craft the item as long as you have the requirements. And that is, guys, how you can craft anything. Be them swords, wood bows, crossbows, boomerangs, even armor. Look, let's select a random armor piece. It's gonna ask for linen yarn, you already know how to get that. It's also gonna be asking for diamonds, which you also know how to get now, and that is it. Same for amulets, there you have it. It's gonna ask for silver cubes, we've just got some earlier, and for diamonds. Once more, you know how to get all of these. And this is pretty much it, the rough core of the crafting system. The only thing that I haven't covered are how to get specific foods or potions. I may do a video for this separately, but yeah, let me know what you think about this. Hopefully it was helpful to you. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you on the next one.